What's going on, guys? Etika from the Etika World Network here, and today I'm not really going to be having news, but a lot of speculation, because as time goes on, obviously the Direct is going to get a lot of leakers out there on 4chan, NeoGAF, etc. People who claim that they have inside information. We've seen examples of this countless times in the past. So one example that I saw today, I don't really believe this is real at all, but I wanted to bring it up because it made me think, hey, isn't it possible for a Direct to have the Ballot characters revealed in the beginning of it? I think this is probably something that's going to go down. Maybe it's a conclusion that all you guys thought of already, but I thought it was interesting regardless. So let's see what this leak said. I'll have this in the description. It got archived. That means zero, but I mean, isn't archiving part of a vote system on 4chan? But I mean, I don't know. I've seen some threads that are like bullshit, but they're totally archived. So I mean, whatever the case may be, nothing can be taken from this. But obviously, it lists a bunch of crazy stuff that I'm not really going to read through, because most of it I don't really find interesting. Well, I do find it interesting, but none of this seems like stuff that, well, some it can realistically happen, I guess. But I mean, I still think the whole list is fake, so there's no need in going through all that. But one thing that I saw at the beginning was Smash Ballot results, 6 characters, 3 available after the Direct. That got me wondering, like, it's possible that they could reveal basically the characters that the Direct has, that the characters at the Ballot has. I'm sorry, all that fucking dancing got me hyped up, man. My brain is like fucked up from all the lack of oxygen and shit. But I mean, how possible do you think it is that when the Nintendo Direct finally goes down, we could potentially see the Ballot characters? I think that's a very high chance, and maybe that's why the Direct is taking so long to put out there, because they know for a fact that they're going to at least reveal who the characters are. Will it be 6? I don't know, I doubt that. There were some people that were data mining and found that there were an amount of slots available in the game. I can't remember exactly how many though, but I don't think it's going to be up to 6 characters. Maybe 2. I believe, maximum, but 6 would be kind of a little bit over the top, and out of those 2 character slots that they most likely will reveal, I'm thinking that all the characters that have been looking like the most popular on the internet in various places, like Smashified, Arteomni, and other ballots that have happened on the internet, Reddit, and then my own ballot as well too, which kind of went to hell due to hackers, but all those characters that are listed in the top 10 of my ballot seem to be getting the most votes all over the internet, with Snake being a surprise vote, but then again, at the same time, I'm not surprised, because a lot of people, you know, do vote for veterans. If it's Snake and Wolf that come back, that'll be all well and good, but I'm really hoping that it'll be a brand new character. Everyone's asking me who I would prefer to see in the ballot, but at this point now, as this is the same opinion that a lot of the other figureheads in Smash Brothers, you know, I shouldn't say figureheads, I suppose, just notable names in Smash, we all kind of have the same perspective. I mean, if there's a new character in general, I don't really care. I'm just happy that we're able to get a character that people have been, you know, voting for, or that has a high amount of popularity in the game period. Regardless of if it's Shovel Knight or Shantae, I'm happy whoever the hell we get. And a lot of people are super opinionated about this, but I feel like you shouldn't be so rigid in terms of who you want in the game, and then when you don't get that character, you get disappointed. Think about the fact that we're getting a character in Smash Brothers that's going to be a fan vote from the Smash Ballot. And I know, don't tell me that Sakurai said no one's getting in by voting, it's just by popularity or by who he decides. At the end of the day, the ballot is ran by the amount of push that people have for one character. So obviously, there's a lot of excitement just with that fact. So I would love it, regardless of who it is. I mean, King K. Rool, Shantae, the difference to me is very minimal. There are some characters that I obviously do have more of a passion behind, but even if they don't get in, I'm totally fine with that, man. As long as we get something new, I'm happy. So what are the chances that the Smash Ballot is going to be revealed during the Direct? Maybe they're going to do something even crazier and surprise us with the characters available after the Direct, which would be mind-blowing, because I mean, how the hell will they have all these characters done by the time the Direct is out? Maybe by the end of the year, December? I don't know. I mean, it's possible, because like I said, maybe Nintendo took note of who their front runners were from a while ago, so they already knew to prepare the DLC characters. But then again, I don't see that happening, because Mewtwo, when he was revealed around this time of year, he was pushed until spring. So, I mean, you can't judge too hard, but still, I'm excited regardless. Are you hype for the fact that the Direct could potentially reveal the Smash Ballot characters? I definitely am, and I think the chances are extremely high. It's got to be why the Direct is taking so long. So one thing I'm going to do at some point before the Direct is announced, which hopefully will happen soon, I'm going to make a little bit of a Direct, what do you call it? I mean, those Nintendo Direct sheets, whereas those bingo cards, where you kind of put the marker as you're watching on what you guessed. So we're going to make some predictions here for the next Nintendo Direct as well too. Are you excited about that? I'm probably going to do it on stream. So the Nintendo Direct prediction stream from me, we're going to be looking at a bunch of speculative ideas like these, and we're going to pick out which one are most possible, because right now, F-Zero X3D on the Wii U, I don't think this is possible at all. They specifically mentioned that F-Zero ain't gonna be on the Wii U, or they haven't specifically said that, but they've said that the Wii U is not favorable. The words from Shigeru Miyamoto himself, the controller isn't really viable for the F-Zero franchise, even though I don't think that's possible because there's so many control schemes on the Wii U, but I mean, whatever. They know gaming better than me. I'm not a designer, right? Anyways, guys, let me know what you think about all this, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Take care of yourselves, and of course, as usual, please have yourself a damn good one.